And whoever doesn't believe inside his creed, whoever doesn't believe that the souls have connection with the body, they don't belong to the Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah. Why? Because this Aqeedah is the Aqeedah of the Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah, like the scholars have stated. Like Allama Sakhawi has mentioned, there is Ijma' consensus on this. Finally, there is an issue and debate within the public regarding Hayati and Mamati. And some people say, brothers, there are two groups inside the Deoband. There are two groups inside the Deoband. You have the Hayatis and you have the Mamatis. You have those people who believe regarding the life of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam inside his grave, and you have others that don't believe, who are regarded as Mamatis. Let me make this very clear, my brothers. Those people, whether they belong to the subcontinent or not, whether they've read in a Deobandi madrasa or not, and who believe that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam soul has no connection with the body, al-jism al-ansari, the body that's inside the grave which we see in Medina, the grave, whoever doesn't believe that there's a connection with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam soul and his body, and he's not alive inside his grave, he has no ta'alluq and connection with the creed of the ulama of Deoband. No connection. Let me make this very, very clear today. Because people say you have division inside ulama of Deoband. There's two groups. There is no two groups. We have one group, and this group is the group of Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah. This I have in front of me. Aqaid Ahl Sunnah. Al-Muhannad al-Mufannad. This is written by Allama Khalid Ahmad Sarampuri. The same person who's written the outstanding commentary on Abu Dawood. He has written the official Aqeedah of Ulama of Deoband. Official Aqeedah. And this Aqeedah has been signed over 20 scholars of Saudi, Masjid Haram and Masjid Nabawi. Great teachers, great a'imma of these two places have signed this creed and have said that this creed of the ulama of Deoband is according to the Quran and Sunnah and is according to Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah. Reputable scholars of Masjid Haram and Masjid Nabawi who taught in the masajid, who taught in the madaris at that time, they have clearly signed this. There's over 20 names in here. I don't want to go detail into this. But this is the official book of Aqeedah. Inside this book, Allama Khalid Ahmad Sarampuri rahimahullah has clearly mentioned that the prophets are alive inside their grave. They're alive inside there. And there's a connection of the soul and the body. And he's quoted Allama Suyuti, who I've quoted before, and he's quoted Taqiyuddin al-Subki, and he's quoted Mawlana Qasim Nanutvi rahmatullahi alayhi. So this book is the official book of Aqeedah of Ulama Deoband. And let me make this clear. Those people who are obsessed, or who are, as I say, rather jealous of the work that have been presented by the Ulama of Deoband, and they go around confusing the Muslim Ummah by presenting stories to them, by presenting kashf to them, by presenting other things and saying this is the Aqeedah of Ulama of Deoband. Let me make it very clear today, these people are nothing but liars. These people are nothing but liars. They are fraudsters. How can a person present a story and saying this is the Aqeedah? Our Aqeedah is not based on if you have objection, object this book and we will answer inshallah. If you have objection, let me make this very clear today. If any person has objection on the creed of ulama of Deoband, object the official book of creed. If you want to object creed, object the book of creed. If you want to object hadith, object the book of hadith. If you want to object tafsir, object the book of tafsir. How can this be possible? A person objects creed and he brings the storybook. This is absurd. Regarding the story, the Prophet said, "Bayyinu an hadithu an bani Israel wala haraj." There's no problem in narrating stories. We don't base our aqeedah on stories. Our aqeedah is based on Quran and authentic Sunnah. So if anyone has a problem with the creed and aqeedah of ulama Deoband, answer this. Object this, and inshallah is my job with the permission of Allah and the fadl of Allah to answer inshallah. So this is very clear. Inside here is made it clear that the creed of ulama of Deoband is, when the ulama of Saudi asked, that our aqeedah is that the Prophet Allah alayhi salatu wasalam is alive inside his and he's quoted Suyuti and As-Subki rahimahumullah ta'ala. Also, this I have in front of me. تسكين الصدور في تحقيق أحوال الموتى في البرزخ والقبور. By the great Imam Ahl Sunnah, Sheikh Safraz Khan Safdu rahimahullah, he has mentioned Akabir Deoband ka maslak aur unka muttafaq ailan. Maslak Hayatul Nabi. That the elders of Deoband and their agreement, their collective announcement, their collective, in here there are 10 signatures of 10 great scholars, amongst whom Mufti Shafi Saab, Rahimahullah, the father Muftaqi Al Uthmani, Mawla Yusuf bin Nuri Saab, Alama Zafar Ahmad Uthmani, who has written I'la Sunan, the encyclopedia of the Hanafi school of thought. 10 signatures of great reputable scholars who have also mentioned that whoever has this aqeedah that the prophets are not alive in the grave, they don't have any connection with the maslak of ulama of Deoband. So those people like Mufti Shafi, Mullah Yusuf bin Nuri, Alama Zafar Ahmad Uthmani, Sheikh Safraz Khan Safdar Rahimallah, who have mentioned that they have no connection with ulama of Deoband, who are the people today who don't even represent ulama of Deoband to say that we are Deobandis. I hope this masala is clear. Because then people object is that there's a group in Deoband that don't believe in that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is alive inside his grave. Na'udhu billah min dhali. We have this aqeedah that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is alive inside his grave, and we give salam from far, the angels convey the message to him, and if we give salam next to his grave, he hears himself and he gives jawab answer, like I've proven from Quranic ayat, Quranic verse, ahadith, and quotes of the scholars. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the tawfiq and ability to stay firm on the true creed of the Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us all from the ways of shaitan. Wa akhir da'wana, alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.